Hello there. How's it going, everyone? Happy Monday. We're gonna be doing some Red Dead Redemption here. Let me just make sure things are in order. There we go. Okay, we're gold. Alright. Let's get right into it. Sure, everything is all in order. Nothing is muted. Okay, everything looks good. All right, I think we're in the clear. Let's do it. Getting pretty close to the end here. I'm gonna attempt to try and play this game every Monday and Friday. And then Wednesday I'll leave open for some sort of multiplayer game like Battlefield or something like that. Oh man, that's pretty bright. Was not expecting that. Alright. Letter arrives for you. Return to the camp to read this. And of course, always the autosave. See this letter.
What the hell going on around here? Dutch is crazy as a cat.
Dear sir, you were once very kind to Beau and myself, and it pains me to ask you to show us further kindness. But I have nowhere else to turn, and nobody else upon whom I can impose. I will, of course, pay you handsomely for your troubles. My family have turned quite mad and are threatening to send me away to stop my work, which they say is disgracing them. As if their history of absolute moral depravity, utter debauchery, and perpetual drunkenness did not disgrace them enough. I must escape, yet I am kept prisoner here. Can you help? Most days I am to be found at the cabins on the plantation. The main house and all it stood for are thankfully no more. Yours faithfully, Penelope Braithwaite.
All right, let's go visit Penelope. go to Rhodes. Oh, we get some nice travel music here. Some nice scenery going on too. Some beauty shots. I'm kinda Randy. Probably gonna say your name wrong here, but how's it going? Zerky? I'm pretty sure. I don't even know how to say that. Zerky? I don't even know, but how's it going, man? Kinda Randy. It's kind of one of the decisions that I had on my name. You failed me. Oh man, I'm sorry. We have met before, have we? Sure have. Well, my memory is all sorts of messed up. But I have absolutely the best memory. Forgot though, but we have. Well, welcome back then. We have met before. You know Zen or Rathic? Yes. I know both of them.
You there? Yeah. Would you watch my cargo here while I go find someone to deal with this?
Okay.
Yes. Thank you, sir.
I'd be murky. Okay.
I won't stop you.
Well, there, that's how we met through them. I'm Murky. Okay. I know the name, but
it's probably just a busted wagon.
It's not ringing like too many bells, but I definitely know the name. May have met you through Flips. I don't know who Flips is. But anyways, welcome in, Murky. Finally getting your name right. Isn't there supposed to be like a dead body in here? Yeah, there's a dead body in here. That's Catherine. Good, I'm not ringing any bells, so I don't think you would hear bells. Surprised this place isn't hostile to me. Oh, you know, as soon as I say something. They are pretty hostile to me. I wonder if it's because I sold the what's call it. Damn hats blocking my shots. I don't know if I could shoot her. She's so far away. I'm being charged for assault. All right, let's ride away and hopefully escape the law. Find some place to hide somewhere around here. Eventually that witness sign will get out of the corner. Yeah, how's your day so far, Murky? It's been storming like crazy here. Here in Connecticut. We had like crazy winds going on. Let's let these lawmen pass by. Yeah. Okay. Let's now try to do the mission. Penelope.
Oh, you came. You came. You finally came.
I came.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, you lovely, lovely man.
Calm down, miss.
Oh, come on. Let's go. We ain't got a minute to lose. They killed her. They killed Miss Calhoun. All she wanted was a better lot for women, and they killed her, those pigs.
Who killed her?
I don't know. My cousins, probably, or Beau's. You met them. They're animals. Not even animals. Monsters. Monsters, if God had lost all his powers of imagination. Can you please take me to the train station? Bo'll be waiting.
Bo, why couldn't he come and rescue you?
Well, if they saw me and him together, they'd lynch him and send me off to a nunnery. Or maybe they'd lynch us both, I ain't quite sure. They do so love hanging folk.
Where you heading?
Up to Boston.
Good. Yeah, I like you up there. Come on. Let's go.
Boston. Alright, let's get Penelope out of here.
I'm in your hands. Just get me to Rhodes Railway Station.
Okay, let's try and get you a train. Bo's just waiting at the station in the hope you'll show up. Or I'll show up to help you show up.
He goes to there every day he can. Makes up some excuse or other. I said he would see me there one day soon, and today he will. God willing.
Well.
Hopefully, Bo is waiting there.
I've hardly seen him since the rally. They watch me so carefully, and he's waited, or so his letters say. Our families won't let us out. And then all that business with Aunt those boys killed. I have so much bloodshed. You'd think this could be a new beginning, but everyone left alive. They're even more angry.
Maybe anger's a complicated thing to let go of.
Something.
Well, let's get me all sorted out here. That one's a modded out one.
Has to come out of this awful, awful feud.
That's what I've been hoping.
There he is. Oh, it's him. Will you ride on the train with us a little? Just the first stop?
Fine.
Hey, Bo.
You came at last, you came.
Oh, Bo, my sweet. My best of men.
Oh, I'm hardly a man at all. But I love you, Penelope Braithwaite. Sir, how can we ever repay your kindness?
Some of them jewels would do just fine.
Bo, Arthur's gonna join us. I think we need the support. Please, could you buy the tickets, dear Mr. Morgan? We can't chance being seen.
Sure.
Thank you. We'll meet you on the platform.
The Weldon. Long time no see.
Can I have 3 tickets to San Denis, please, sir?
Of course. Oh, hello, sir.
Hello, Alden. I hope all is well.
Not terribly. But good to see you.
Hey, cousin. No. Hey, no, you're slow. Penelope, get back. Oh.
Excuse me, Alden. Get on the train. Get your bags, miss. I got this.
Come here, Yankee.
With pleasure, you goddamn fool. You want to come back here without giving you a whipping?
All right. We should have done this last time.
Get on the train, son. Go to your woman. No, now there's only one of you.
There we go. Let me get my hat before I hop on.
Goodbye, folks.
Hello, future.
Almost.
All right, all done. That is quite a family you got there, son.
I know. Charming to the last. Then again, my uncle used to keep his own half-brother as a slave, so what do you expect, good manners?
My uncle used to say things were better the way they were, when he could rape and kill with impunity, and he didn't have to work a day in his life.
Both our families. There's good people in this county, but our families bullied them and drove most of them off, whites as well as blacks, all over this silly feud.
Yeah, well, how do life?
Oh, my lord.
What? Oh, I think it's my second cousin.
What is with it with all these goddamn cousins?
I think they found out about the jewels.
All right, keep your heads down. We'll deal with this. Jewels? I knew you had some damn jewels.
Oh, come over the hill.
You must have all the jewels in the state.
I missed that shot. Got a bit of a war train going on here.
I am no brute. Stay
Hold tight, all right? I'll take a look up front.
What will you do?
I'll figure it out. All
right. Look at me, chat. I'm the conductor now. Got some vice in here. Got some bison boys. One long train drive going on here. Oh, cutscene. Cutscene over the bridge.
It's best you go on alone from here.
Mr. Arthur, I didn't know you could drive a train.
Neither did I. But if I'm honest, it was kind of fun. And I didn't kill any of us. Well, I killed some of your relatives. They would have killed all of us.
You are a gentleman, sir.
Oh, no, I ain't.
Yes, you are. Here, I ain't got much money, but these sapphires are worth a lot of money. Old family heirloom.
That Braithwaite treasure.
I mean, we already got the brooch earlier, so let's just give it to them.
No. Let's get you off to Boston before any more of your relatives show up.
That might be wise.
Hey, you there.
Yeah?
This couple is heading up north to the Boston line. They got money, they'll pay you on arrival. That work for you?
Yeah, sounds fine. Get on in.
Hey, you carry protection on a journey like this?
I wouldn't be much of a stage driver if I didn't. Goes everywhere I do. Hey!
Miss Braithwaite is going to hold on to this until arrival. On account of the treasure on your person.
I don't know how to thank you.
You're a fine man, sir.
Just get out of here. I'll leave.
I could have just given her one of my guns. Pretty sure I have something that I don't use. Pretty certain. Alright.
with you momentarily. Liberty is worth every penny.
I guess I don't have any bounties to pay.
Oh dear. Have you come down with the flu as well, sir?
Flu? No. What are you talking about?
Nothing. It's just been going around, that's all. Anyway, how can I help you?
I guess I can't pay for any train tickets. Alright, let's head on back.
Okay, my girl.
Yep.
Where can we go here? Let's head up to Wallace Station. It's gotta be my favorite station in this whole entire game. Something about Wallace Station is very, very homey. We got some O'Driscolls around here.
Whoa, easy.
We go in the back and come out the back.
We just eat some salted beef. Some cheese. Let's just dance a little here in circles. There we go.
O'Driscolls, was you?
They were O'Driscolls. Now they're just dead O'Driscolls. Look at that guy. It's a train going by. Yeah, let me have some more of that salted meat. We have that half-eaten bread chunk. Oh no, I don't want the hat. Get that out of here. I want my hat. Okay. Let's continue on somewhere. Let's continue on to Wallace Station.
Yep.
Okay. Let's see what we got up here.
Out of the damn way.
Jeez, Arthur. It's good enough road for the both of us. Okay. Let's have some more cheese. Is there anything else? Chocolate bar? Train tickets.
Y'all right there, sir?
Yes. Why?
Been some grip going around here, and I just thought, you know what? Never mind. What can I do for you?
Let's go to Ansburg.
Thanks. See you again soon.
You look like you're in the circus or theater or something.
You know, eventually I'll go to Ansburg. So it seems like Arthur is not happy with the situation he's in. With everybody keep asking if he's okay. Sounds like the winds have finally died down around my parts. Remember when I woke up, felt like the house was moving. My house was shifting. I always hate waking up to that. Am I wanted? Yeah, wanted dead or alive in these parts. Oh boy. Okay. Let's fully mod out.
This must be your first time here.
This
yes.
Stupid Lancaster that I have. Because it's driving me nuts that I keep.
You've
defaulting to this one
as nice as the day you bought it. Well
instead
done.
Of the other one.
Are you interested in any rifling in this one? Give your bullets a nice twist rate.
There, we'll just.
You'll see an immediate improvement.
We'll only change the color to that.
You know, this weapon would look even more impressive with some engraving. What do you think?
Change it to that one.
I hear there was a big shootout with the Murphy gang in the caves.
Thanks. Excuse me.
You're excused, guy.
Was you followed?
No.
Was you followed?
I said no.
Okay.
What is your problem?
What is your problem, partner? You don't look so good.
What is wrong with you?
Nothing wrong with me. I'm fit as a fiddle.
And I inside you ain't.
I'm just a realist, friend.
Micah reckons there's a rat. Oh, does he? On what evidence?
He's only back a minute. Pinkerton show up.
We've been on the run since you two fools went crazy in Blackwater. We barely escaped with our lives in Saint Denis. Now we got a rat.
Well, Molly clearly talked, but who else?
Maybe we pushed things too hard. Maybe time for folks like us is past. We don't need a rat. We got sloppier than the town drunk, and they know who we are and where we are and what we're doing.
Way I see it, best thing we can do is let the wheat go. Move on, get our money, and start over.
That ain't happening. Well, something's gotta happen, and fast. Otherwise, Cornwall, them Pinkertons, they've got us penned in here, and ain't none of them stopping.
Well, Cornwall's why we're here. Shall we, Dutch?
Yeah, it's time to go. Let's head to the river.
Leave Cornwall alone. He ain't. We need money. But revenge? Now?
Of course it's for money.
Come on, Arthur.
This better not be no stupid revenge mission, Dutch. It ain't worth it.
Don't be ridiculous.
Oh, Arthur, it's just a simple social call.
Simple social call. Of visiting enemies.
So what are we gonna say to him that needs to be said?
He has been hunting us since Valentine. He is the reason that Hosea got killed. His sugar business is destroying the people of Guarma. This town, Arthur, it's his town. He bought it just to destroy these folks. His sugar, his oil, his law.
These are wrongs that you can't right, Dutch. We're wanted men.
So why did you go for John against my wishes?
I didn't want him hanged.
Neither did I.
We're gonna cut a deal, Arthur.
What are you talking about?
We want out, and Cornwall wants us to stop robbing him, and we all know his money is what's keeping the Pinkertons on our tail. He's America, Arthur, and I want out, and he won't let us go.
This ain't making a lot of sense, Dutch.
It will, son. It will. A deal, some noise, and then we're gone.
Deal and some noise.
Cornwall's boat is due in soon. Let's get down here behind these crates.
Time to hide behind this crate here.
I want to thank you for your hospitality, Mr. Cornwall.
This was a business meeting, Mr. Milton. We are not friends. I have spent a considerable fortune with your agency. And still nothing. This Vanderlyn robs me and laughs at me. I asked for the best. I paid for the best.
We are very close, Mr. Cornwall. I know you've heard this before.
Can't, sir. Send a telegram to Goldberg in New York. Tell him I won't borrow it more than 3.2%. Sorry, no, I have heard it before. And get that army man to pay his portage charge.
Yes, sir.
We are doing all we can within the confines of the law.
The law? I think we both know what you can do with your law. Find me Dutch Vanderlyn. Bring him here and leave the laws to them as need them. Good day, sir.
Come along, Mr. Ross. We have work to do.
Mr. Didsbury. Mr. Cornwall.
Now listen up, Didsbury. What's all this about strikes? I bought into this mine because of mismanagement. And I intend to make it a success, no matter what the cost.
It's the wages. Folk feel
Folk
that you...
feel? Business doesn't give two figs about feelings, sir. Not two figs. It's a nonsense that will bring a plague on both our houses, sir.
Perhaps there is a plague on your house already, Mr. Cornwall.
What do you want, sir?
I'm not quite sure just yet.
Your impudence will be your undoing, sir.
I'm undone already. Even my best friend here, he thinks I'm crazy. And like this poor fellow you are talking to, my feelings are hurt.
You robbed me, sir.
And you robbed him. Funny world.
You show a criminal's grasp of sophistry, sir. I did no such thing.
You kill. I kill. You rob. I rob. Only difference I can see is I choose whom I kill and rob and you destroy everything in your path.
I've heard just about enough.
I'll tell you what. You give me this ship, $10,000, and safe passage out of here, I'll let you live.
I'll do no such thing.
You sure? Good. I prefer it this way.
You lost your man!
Noise, Arthur! Noise!
Such a surprise, Pinkertons are here. It isn't like Ross and what's his face? Milton weren't just here.
Mike is going after those papers. Let's find him and get out of here.
And I should probably brought a shotgun. Let's hide a little bit. Playing a little bit too aggressive here. How am I supposed to shoot that oil wagon if... Oh, okay, never mind. If everybody's taking my cover... Oh, man, I don't think I'm gonna last too long here. Especially with the aim like that.
Come on, we can take the horses from that coach. Let's go.
Well, at least we tried talking it out.
Boys, you've lost your minds. Oh, I felt a lot of guilt in this life, Arthur. I've killed too often and poorly, but not this time, son. Come on. All right, let's head for the hills, boys. They're trying to block us off. Go right.
Let's run to the hills. Run for our lives. no idea where I just got shot from.
Social call.
No, oh, don't play dumb and superior at the same time, Morgan. We all knew, sooner or later, Cornwall had to go.
Let me see them papers.
It's more attention we don't need. Feels like the whole world's closing in on us. Dutch, it won't be long before they find where we're hiding out now. Especially as we ain't exactly hiding out.
We just need a distraction. Buy us some time. Looks like Mr. Cornwall's company has signed a railroad contract with the army. And they're also moving dynamite down from, well, the Annisburg mines to San Denis to resell. And there's bonds at his oil factory. Maybe there's a way to get them off our back and get the money that we need. Micah, you look into this dynamite. Take Bill, I guess. Arthur, you go too. We are gonna need a lot of it. And Micah, we need to talk. Figure out some things.
Of course, boss.
Figure out what?
The plan. Getting out of here. Nothing's changed.
It hasn't, huh?
There's an old house west of Van Horn. Meet me there when you can, Black Lung.
Let's split up. We'll meet up back at camp.
Yeah.
It's like Arthur kind of grew some mutton chops in the time of getting on that train and going to Annisburg. Going on here. Let's eat some beef.
Stop it. Stop it. Just go away. Stop it.
Howdy.
I just don't want him to see me. We're not friends anymore. We're not. They won't forgive you. They didn't forgive me. There is no forgiveness. None, friend. None. I know you want it. I can smell it on you. Well, it ain't happening. No, 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 it isn't. That's why, that's why I'm out here, well away from them. See, they come for me, but I'm watching. Yeah. I never sleep. I never do.
Okay. Although, let me have some of this plant here. I guess he's just gonna sleep right there.
Giddy up.
Yeah. It's one way how to live. See what Reverend wants.
Reverend,
You okay, Mr. Morgan?
I don't know, Reverend.
These are challenging times for all of us.
Yes, very challenging.
You don't seem yourself somehow.
I've always felt... I've left the morphine, sir.
Arthur, Reverend Swanson, would you excuse us a minute?
Of course.
New York? We are going to go to New York. Now, they have been chasing us south and east and west. We're going to get a boat, we're going to get on a river, and we're going to go north.
New York.
Then Tahiti, the Fiji Islands, or this place, New Guinea, dancing girls, freedom. But first, we have to make a whole lot of smoke, a whole lot of commotion. And then we disappear.
We need more commotion?
One score and one whole hell of a lot of noise.
We ain't so good at doing scores anymore, Dutch.
Are you feeling all right, Arthur?
Sure, fine.
Pardon me for interrupting. I brought a friend, Arthur.
Hello.
Hello.
Dutch, this is Eagle Flash. His father is a great chief. Charles and I, we...
pretended to be mercenaries. Did me a great favor.
Dutch Vanderlyn. How do you do?
Not well, sir.
Well, I am sorry to hear that.
How's your father?
Father has confused wisdom with weakness. His people, my people, we've suffered too much, been lied to too much. Now they've taken our horses.
Who?
The infantry division posted at Fort Wallace.
Why?
Colonel Favors is a liar and a murderer. His people won't stop until we're all dead. Without horses, we cannot hunt. Without hunting, we will starve. This is another act of war.
I see that.
Men have helped me before, and I have money.
Put your money away, son. What do you think, Charles?
You know I told your father I will not fight over some horses.
But I made no such promise. Come along.
Yeah. Arthur, we must go with them. Try to stop things from getting out of hand.
I guess. Come along.
Me and Charles taking over the world.
I know. I understand Eagle Flies is angry, but I don't see how this will help anything.
Especially not with Dutch whipping him up into a frenzy. Got enough folks coming after us without adding armor to the list.
Walk all over you? No, you're not. This is all that's wrong with this world.
Okay, young man, lead the way.
The horses are on a boat near Van Horn. I have a man waiting for us there with some canoes.
Surely this can be done without killing anyone.
Of course. What will be, will be. Anyway, son, tell me about this Colonel Favors.
He's a vile man. He and his regiment take pleasure in persecuting us. All the young have been taken from our reservation, shipped off to reform schools. Many women, too. The old are weak and sick, but they deliberately withhold medicine and supplies from us.
This ends today. You have my word on that. Why are you getting involved in this, Dutch? You know me. We shoot fellers as need shooting. We save fellers as need saving. Feed them as need feeding. Not this again. It's been quite a while since we helped anyone but ourselves, and even you know that. I told you, noise. We need noise, Arthur. Noise and faith.
I still the hell was don't that? Know
what that means. Stop questioning and think. Just think. For a second, the Pinkertons have had time to reinforce. The civilized world is closing on us. Who knows what else Molly
is that a nude there? Man running after some wolves
now? Sure, but what's this got to do with any of that? Some good honest conflict between the army and the Indians might be just the distraction we need. Kill two birds with one stone. Cornwall was funding the Pinkertons' assault on us. Why do you think I dealt with him? With Cornwall gone, the government is far more likely to to divert them to other issues, especially if there's one more scandal. And then we can slip away. Like I said, we just need that noise and one more score. You know, I went back for the chest I had hidden outside Shady Bell, and we're close, Arthur. That dynamite, the railroad contract with the army, it was all in those papers Micah found. I have a plan. You just have to trust me.
Trust plans, faith.
There's Peta.
These men, like I said, they'll help us.
I got the canoes. The boat is still moored in the channel.
Good. Let's wait until nightfall. All right. Let's head out.
I like how the other boat, both of them are paddling, but this one, only I'm paddling. Hey guys, let's have the person with TB only paddle.
We'll be ashore before anybody even knows what happened.
Easy, they're gonna hear us.
Try not to kill anyone, Arthur.
I like how they said try not to kill anyone, and I strangled that guy, and then I snapped their neck. Maybe we need to go around the other side. Come on, Charles. What are you doing, man?
What the hell?
We'll take it back, what's ours?
Okay, I'll just keep on kicking him until he's knocked out. I like how they're like, we don't need to kill anybody, and they're the ones who start shooting. And now we're gonna drown the boat with a whole bunch of knocked out people. or what I'm gonna assume is gonna drown the boat. Yeah, see?
Well, whatever else is wrong with you, you're quite the best pilot I've ever come across.
The horses are confused. We need to round them up. I'll get these four, Arthur. Can you go after the others?
Okay.
I thought you were getting the other horses, Arthur.
Okay, I guess I'll get the other horses. That one just came up and thought I was gonna just ride that one. Well, let me mount the horse before I drown. Let me please mount a horse.
There
we go. Are they gonna follow me? Yeah, they are. Okay, cool. Horse boats.
So much treachery and betrayal that a man can take before...
Will one of you help me return the horses to my men?
Well, Arthur needs to rest. I will. I like you, son. And after the horses, are we gonna wait for the army to come and wreak its revenge?
I hope not.
Of course we ain't. Now let's go check out that fort of theirs.
Is this a good idea?
This is the only idea, and it is one that will suit both of our purposes.
Fighting the army ain't wise.
Stop worrying. Oh, and Sadie told me about Cone. Meet us at Doyle's Tavern in Saint Denis when you can. Shall we go, son?
Certainly.
We'll start some light reconnaissance out at Fort Wallace, and when Combs dealt with, you come meet us there. We'll set up a good spot for you.
I don't know, Dutch.
Yeah, well, I do. This is exactly the distraction that we need.
Your father said that fighting was an impossible gamble. There's no winning for you in this.
Your father need not know anything. He'd rather live in ignorance.
Come along, gentlemen.
Your father would rather you did not do anything so foolish. I said I would stop this from happening. Would you talk to him?
Speak with Rangeful.
Yes. Would you?
Yeah, let's help Rainsfall.
Sure. I'll speak with him. You head on back to camp, check on the others, touch his behavior.
I understand.
Thank you, Arthur.
Somehow I got a gold medal on that. Okay, let's travel to, Micah needs something. Let's travel down, let's go see Micah since we're here. Better yet, let's do the stranger mission in town. Van Horn, but this one here.
Yeah.
Sounded like you. He said boo. You know, this right here has got to be my favorite riding music in the whole game. Something about that plucking going on sounds pretty good.
You're my savior, sir.
That was a terrible thing to see. Get back to town. Make yourself well.
I shall, sir. I shall. And I shan't forget the kindness you've done to me.
Go on. Uh-oh. Yeah, that was a close one. I must just ram myself off the cliff. Okay. Let's see what's going on with
I said hell, even a blind hog finds an acorn every once in a while.
With the Downs woman.
You want company, boys?
Sure, because I want to be pissing needles tomorrow.
This is down. This country is man unleashed. That's the thing, and it ain't my fault any more than it's anyone else.
Man unleashed? Then unleash goodness, not just hell's feeble brothers, sir.
But how? I mean, all I know how to do is fight, I guess. I was set free to fight. Where's your son, Mrs. Down?
Where you think. Down the mine. Until he gets sick. Which won't be long, given how hard they work him. See, foremen don't like him, so he gets the worst of it.
Maybe I could go with...
Well, maybe you could just leave us all alone. Maybe. Maybe you could just go fight some other battle.
Let's go to the mine. Going against her wishes. She's also not looking too good.
Why don't you shut up? Oh, all right.
Who's this, your daddy?
My daddy died. And this man, he killed him. What are you doing here?
Leave the boy alone. Why'd you kill his daddy? You after his mama?
Stop bullying the boy.
Get out of my business, mister.
Leave the boy alone.
Or what?
I'll kill you too.
You couldn't kill no one. Look at you, all ragged and sick and weak. Clear off, you goddamn hermit. Clear off! You and the horse son here.
Double teamed over here.
Now who's next?
Let the boy go.
Let him go. Come with me. Shame on you. He's just a goddamn boy.
Let's get you out of here.
They're gonna kill me. Now I got no job and they're gonna kill me.
I've got some money. You and your mama can go someplace nice.
Well, why are you doing this?
I don't know. Listen, take this. All of it.
Try and talk to your mama. And get out of here. Now run.
I'll try.
Good boy. I don't want to see you here again.
That wasn't too hard. Got a gold medal out of it, too.
Okay, girl. Hey there.
All right, let's go see what Mike is up to. There's something dead over here. There's a dead person over here. Oh. There we go, tumbling. Say, lost letter to Bonnie, Miss McFarlane. I'm sorry, I can't really read this person's cursive that well. All I got was McFarlane and I'm sorry. Let me get that money clip. So is that guy dead now? No, he's still alive. Some turkeys roaming around. All right, Micah, what you want?
Ah, there he is, old Black Lung Morgan.
Shut up.
Was you followed?
Excuse me?
Was you followed?
Do you know who you're talking to?
I ain't sure. I ain't sure about much no more. All I know is there's law whenever you're around.
Is that so? Because it seems to me the
since you've been riding with us, there ain't been nothing but trouble. Stirring things up all the time, getting in Dutch's ear. Seems wherever you is, there's Pinkertons and vice versa. So you better watch your goddamn mouth, boy! Or...
Take it easy, cowboy. You're gonna do yourself a mischief, way you're heading.
Micah, shut it!
He started it! Dutch says we is to go on with plans to create a diversion. We gotta get some explosives to blow up the bridge. Keep the army out of here a few days.
I think it's a real bad idea.
I don't think Dutch cares too much what you think.
That's clear.
We gotta confuse him one last time. Then he and I will head to Blackwater, collect the money, and help everyone leave. He's got a boat lined up.
Blackwater's a fool's errand. Everyone knows it. Even a greedy moron like you.
It's Dutch's choice, Arthur. You're just a senior gun, same as the rest of us. Only you ain't well.
I'm fine.
Then you'll do Dutch's bidding, which is robbing a stage that's coming from Annisburg full of explosives.
Rob a stage. All we seem to ever do is rob a stage, you and me.
Not me. You two. I got my own planning to do. You boys got this.
Shit. Guess we have. Come on, Arthur.
And cowpoke, take it easy. You could do with a vacation, hmm?
And Micah's turning
All
into a
right,
huge
let's
jerk.
Go.
Have fun, boys. Micah says we should jump it as soon as it comes through Van Horn.
So you're taking orders from him now?
I'm taking orders from Dutch, same as always.
Paranam are becoming unhinged. You hear about Dutch killing Cornwall?
Hey, hold up a second. Pinkerton patrol over there. Okay, I think we're clear. Let's head off.
So you was just talking about...
Okay, I need to feed my horse some...
Well, that needed to be done.
Right now? With the Pinkertons breathing down our necks?
See, I'm starting to think that you've gone soft, Morgan. Okay. Let's hold up here. Whoa! So... Wagon will be coming from that way, down from Annisburg. It'll take the two of us to stop it completely, or it'll never get done. So, I was thinking, you go play dead, and I'll take care of him.
No, I'm the better shot, and you're the better actor. No, you play dead, and I'll cover you.
I got that. Oh, that's them coming now, I think. It'll be quite the show.
Arcana rifle, all right. Didn't realize I didn't have a lot of what's called it. Get on the wagon. That is definitely not the way that I wanted to get on the wagon.
All right, let's see if we can get this.
nice drunk brain.
Comes naturally. I could use a drink after that.
I know. Just never goes easy no more, does it? Distraction. So it ain't meant to make sense. It should to us. It's our plan.
You know, I've had it with the moment.
Look, come on, Bill.
There's Mike up ahead.
Great. Whoa! So,
you got it?
We got it. Yes, we got it.
What's wrong, Arthur?
Nothing at all, boss.
John. Go drive this over to Bacchus Bridge. Get it hidden near there.
He really does think he's in charge.
You go on ahead. I need to speak with Arthur. Good work, son.
Son.
What's going on?
Listen. I know we ain't always seen eye to eye, and you find me irritating and a threat, and I like to annoy you. But right now, I need better from you, Arthur.
Okay, Micah. Whatever you say.
I ain't the bad guy you think I am, Arthur. But I am a survivor. Stick with me and you'll live. Oh, the bridge is probably a two-man job. You should probably go help Marston.
Why don't you?
Like I said, Dutch and I got planning to do for the train. There's a big picture here, Arthur. Trust me.
I like how in the beginning he's like, oh yeah, we're brothers. Sometimes brothers make, F2 double-barreled shotguns. Okay. Sometimes brothers make mistakes, but now he's just straight up calling me son now. Camp Stew up?
Morning.
I don't think it is.
How you holding up?
Bad. So I thought Marston was driving the carriage.
Hey, John.
Hey, Charles.
Here we are. Another morning.
Okay. Let's see. So we need to go to Bacchus. Or apparently not. Oh, let's go help Edith. Pretty sure I said her name right.
It fades. Trust me, it fades. What fades?
Your youthful bloom.
It fades.
You all right, girl?
Yeah. Come on, Miss Grimshaw. What the fuck was that? Crazy people, I tell you what. Let's clean my gun here. There we go. We took care of, what are you doing in my neck of the woods type people. Let's keep going. Or better yet, the hills have eyes. She's over here, apparently.
Mr. Morgan.
You still here, kid?
Yes. Mama. Mama can't leave. Or won't leave. I don't know. I said I had the money. She said your money weren't moral. She said it'd be better to die than to take it.
Randy Dandy. Hello, Giggles.
Maybe she's right. I don't know. I don't know anything about morals.
She's still heading out.
More like what Randy Daddy. All right.
Sorry about all
was
this.
Not expecting that hours. At all.
She left with some fella down the railway tracks. I did not like the look of him.
Which way are you doing, saying? Giggles?
That way. Around the woods towards Willard's Rest.
I'll see what I can do.
Step right up, get your news right here.
Let's see. It's,
okay, my girl.
What's going on over here? Hello, friend. How are you? Doing pretty well. Can't really complain too much. I'm doing good. It's good to hear. Search the trail at the bridge. All that trail? I think I found the horse.
That's enough now, partner. You're starting to scare me, let alone the poor woman. Clear off.
Who are you?
Someone who don't want to hear no more of your nasty mouth. Push me. I'll put a bullet in you.
I presume Archie sent you?
I said clear off before I deal with you.
See you again, dearie.
Listen. Listen to me. Excuse me.
You sound like my husband.
I know. Listen, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for what happened. I was a fool. And I'm suffering for my foolishness. But don't go and get yourself killed because of your pride. You have a son. Mrs. Downs.
I'm just so ashamed.
Ashamed? Of what? You loved him. You did everything for him. Let's get you home.
Let's go.
All right. Let's get her home. Let's get her out of this messy spot that she's in.
I'm sorry it had to come to this.
Stop saying sorry. Sorry won't bring Thomas back.
I know.
Are you sick now, too? And you think that affords you the opportunity for penance for cutting his time short?
No, I ain't looking for that.
Okay, then. So just forget about me and the guilt you're carrying, because no good can come of that for either of us. And all you can do now is decide the man you want to be for the time you have left. Help someone who could still be helped. Or help yourself.
Archie should be waiting for us just up ahead.
What's the problem with helping her? People didn't deserve to what happened to them.
Oh, you're so poor. Oh, Archie, what do we do?
Get out of here. Go live someplace else. Start over. Here, take this. I don't need it no more.
I don't want your money.
Yeah, I know you don't want it.
I don't.
You sure as shit need it. Take it.
No.
I ain't looking for forgiveness. It ain't about that. But don't forgive me. Just take the money and get out of here. Please. I know I ruined your life. I suffer for it every day. But don't let yourself get killed for pride. I seen it kill too many folk. Don't say anything. Don't thank me. Just take the money and pack your bags. That's all I gotta say.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan.
I said don't thank me. Get out of here. Please.
Hopefully wherever they end up, it goes well for them. Okay. Let's see what mission I could do here. That's over by Bacchus. Wonder if I can get off at Bacchus Station.
Oh dear. Have you come down with the flu as well, sir?
Flu? No. What are you talking about?
Nothing. It's just been going around, that's all. Anyway, how can I help you?
And the flu's going around everywhere. How close is Wallace Station? Wallace is... pretty far away, so... let's go to Emerald Ranch.
Traveling mercies to you.
I think that's the closest station, that or Valentine, but... they're decent... decent distance away from one another, so I don't think it matters too much. Kinda looks like my horse is like super agitated at let's call it the driver over here. And also I was sitting with someone. It's kinda random.
Yeah.
Okay. It's a stranger mission that I have over here. Oh, okay, that. Oh no. Horse, come back here.
Get me off this horse.
I need to calm the horse down before I can get her off.
Quick! Get me free!
What do you think I'm trying to do, lady?
Tied up like this?
Giving me no time to cut her free.
Thank the Lord you
you showed up when you did. Oh, the things he said he'd do to me.
It's all right, ma'am. It's over now.
Thank you. Again.
All right.
Yep.
Then continue on. Let's see what John's up to.
Arthur,
how you doing?
Nervous? But I've been nervous for a while. I had a lot of time to think in that jail, and I feel like I just don't know Dutch no more.
You ain't the only one.
And this plan to get us out, it just feels, I don't know.
Like you're stringing us along.
Yeah, maybe lighting a match nearby some dynamite isn't the best idea.
Things, but he seems to enjoy it now. It's like he just wants to create more enemies, more chaos.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, I love Dutch. He saved me a long time ago. I feel like in Saint Denis, when I got arrested, maybe he could have done something.
I feel like you should take your woman and child. Get lost.
Do you?
You could give something to Jack. It's that or... Well, I don't see no way out of this.
But what about loyalty?
You're loyal to what matters.
What are you gonna do?
I'll be okay, but do it. For me. It would make me feel good, if that makes any sense.
A little, but...
Listen to me. When the time comes, you gotta run and don't look back. This is over.
And now?
Now we gotta help Dutch give the army one final tweak on its nose.
Yeah, come on. Help me with the rest of this.
Well, it looks like we finally found our calling in life.
Ride this thing out onto the bridge. There's a spot about a third of the way across where we can get down underneath to plant the charges. I've already set up the detonator.
Sure. Let's get this over with. You hear about Dutch and Cornwall?
Yeah. This is what I'm talking about. More enemies? More chaos? I mean, we're about to blow up a bridge, for Christ's sake. Stop. Here's good.
We sure got a lot of this stuff.
We'll need it. I'll climb down there. You lower the crates.
All right. Let me know when you're ready. Got it?
Ready when you are. I'm at the bottom of the ladder here to your left. There's good. Lower it down. Let's get moving here, Arthur. All right, take it slow. That's not something we want to drop. That's it. Okay, good. Grab the other one.
All right, let's get the other one. Pizza delivery man. There we go.
Got it.
All right, come down here and help me plant this stuff. Grab yourself a bundle from the box. The bridge is wired to the detonator. We need to attach each of those bundles to the fuses. There's one on each of the main support beams.
Okay.
I sure hope this is enough to blow it.
These are mining charges. They ain't easy to come by. If they don't do the job, nothing will.
It's kind of weird how they'll just let anybody walk around under these bridges.
Okay, I should go get the handcart ready. You okay to finish off down here?
Sure. Go on, I can handle the rest.
I'll see you up there. This better work. Get up here quick!
Yeah, I'm on my way!
Faster, buddy! Come on!
Shit!
Arthur! A train! Come on, quick! Pump this stupid thing! Hard as you can!
Okay. That I was pumping it correctly, but apparently not. I always hate that stupid handcart. Okay, just time to die here a whole bunch. Okay, there we go. Took me 2 tries. Or 3 tries, I mean. I know how to count.
Thank you. No problem. That just ain't how I want to die. Come on. Let's go blow this thing up. I think the line held. You want the honors?
Sure.
Hey, why not? Well, I'd say it worked.
Well, I guess old Dutch got all the smoke he wants.
Let's hope so.
You really think that that'll draw attention away from us?
I guess we'll see. Tell the truth, I ain't even sure I fully understand Dutch's plan with all this.
Like I said, John, when the time comes, you go.
What about loyalty to everything?
You've been loyal. I've been loyal. Look what that caused. You know, all that ever mattered to me was loyalty. It was all I knew. It was all I ever believed in. Well, not anymore, John. Soon, you gotta go. Go. Don't look back.
I'll think about it.
I've done a lot of thinking. Look at us. Out here risking our necks and for what exactly?
For
an idea that don't work no more.
How you mean?
You know, G. just what I mean. You got a family. You need cash. You need to start building a life for yourself. Me? I need a vacation. And Dutch has all the money for safekeeping.
You know something? Abigail thinks she might know where some of that money is.
Well, you tell her she better make sure. And then come talk to me. And we'll find out just who and what we should be loyal to.
I don't know, Arthur.
Nor do I. But I'm seeing things a lot more clearly now. I wish things were different. But it weren't us who changed.
Yeah!
It's not doing too hot here. Guess he needed a moment to catch his breath. Okay. Let's do one more mission, and we'll call it a stream. Let's go see what's going on at a PD. Let's also study this cow real quick. It's a pretty nice looking cow. Alright, rain falls.
Hello?
Come in. You don't sound very well.
I'm not. I think I'm dying.
Then I hope you find peace.
I don't know too much about peace.
Apparently not. Did you have fun with my son, the impetuous prince? I believe you went on a raid with him.
I'm sorry.
I suppose. the grandeur of a conventional king?
I don't know too many kings.
Colonel Favors, he has already exacted some measure of revenge for the raid. Two women were assaulted by his men.
I'm very sorry about all of this.
Yes. Sometimes the correct path, the bravest path, is the least obvious, and also the gentlest. I'm a great disappointment to my son.
Your son seems to want a war.
My son thinks there is glory in death. Maybe he's right, but for me, I saw death being handed out so freely by the most foolish of men, I never could equate it with victory. Glory has come in service. Maybe. Maybe not, I don't know.
I've killed a lot of people. For a whole lot of dumb reasons, and I ain't never seen much glory in it.
Well, your friend, Mr. Vanderlyn, he talks a lot. I don't know him, but my son is easily led.
I'm not sure I get you.
Well, perhaps we could go for a ride. I'm an old man. My whole life I have tried to bring peace.
But I ain't doing so good.
Then maybe you can take pity on my plight. Please, it won't take long. Maybe I can help you with that cough.
Sir! I'm glad I caught you, sir.
Captain Monroe, you know my friend, Mr. Morgan.
No, sir. I don't have the pleasure.
Arthur Morgan.
It's an honor, sir.
How can I help you, Captain?
I was just in Saint Denis. I spoke with the mayor. It's not good news, I'm afraid. May I ride with you for a little?
Of course.
Follow me.
So where are we going?
I want to show you a site up in the mountains that's long been sacred to me. A place for reflection and healing. What is this news, Captain Monroe?
Yes, sir. As I mentioned, I did speak again with the mayor and the Bureau of Indian Affairs in Saint Denis at length. But regrettably, it appears the oil company has already received approval to move forward with drilling on the reservation's land.
I suppose as much. So what does that mean for us now?
I'm not sure just yet. I didn't get the impression anything would be happening for a few months. I'm very sorry, sir. I did everything I could.
I know, Captain.
And I assure you I will continue to do as much as I can. Mr. Morgan, would you have time to help me at all? I would rather certain actions were taken by friends outside the tribe.
Sure, I can help.
That's good news. Thank you. Come meet me on the reservation whenever you can. Any assistance would be much appreciated, Mr. Morgan. Anyway, gentlemen, I won't take up any more of your time. I'll see you both soon.
Sure.
Thank you, Captain.
Enjoy the ride.
See? What's left of that bridge over there? I heard about it being destroyed. Do you know if that was also my son's doing?
No, I'm pretty sure he had nothing to do with that one.
Well, I fear they will find a way to blame it on us anyway. We'll continue on this way. I'm going to look for some herbs to give you. See the wolves over there feasting on that horse? Brutality and beauty are both all around us. Yet so often we're unable to see past our own grievances. This is what I try to teach my son.
Yeah! Oh, okay!
Good. There was no need to harm them. Are you all right back there? It's best we stay together now.
So, you were saying?
It's a beautiful ride ahead if you need some time to think.
So, we don't know
what's
each other
going on here?
Well, but
what?
I wanted to speak to you about your son. those horses and, well, you know something of Dutch, I think.
Yes, a little. Mostly from your friend Charles.
I don't know why Dutch is getting involved in your situation, and this ain't easy to say, but I just don't trust that he's got your son's best interests at heart.
So what can we do?
I don't rightly know.
Sorry, hold up a moment. That'll have to wait. Some of the plants I need will be growing down here.
It's not that way.
Looking for English mace. Okay, let's continue on. Anyway, you were saying?
I don't rightly know. Charles and I just thought you should be aware. Maybe there's a way to stop things from getting any more out of control.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan. Let me give this some thought.
Ha! You know, I had a son once, years ago. Don't talk about him much.
No, what was his name?
Isaac. His mother, Eliza, the waitress I met. When she got pregnant, she knew who I was, what my life was. I didn't want to promise nothing I couldn't keep, but I said I'd do right by them. Every few months, I'd stop by there for a few days. He was such a good kid. She was too, I guess. Just a kid, 19.
What happened?
I got there one day and saw two crosses outside. I knew right away. Turned out some bastards had come through. Robbed them, shot them dead, and offered $10. It hardened me, feeling that kind.
Wait, stop here. I want to pick some ginseng. We can talk more about this later.
Well, horses are freaking out. Whew, that was kind of rough. Never heard that dialogue before.
Wait there. I'll put these in your saddlebag. Mix these together. It tastes awful, but it'll help to keep your strength up. All right, let's go. It's not much further now.
Now, I was saying, hardened me, feeling that kind of pain. But I know now that you don't get to live a bad life and have good things happen to you.
I think you're being hard on yourself.
Maybe. All I can do now is try and make some things right. And that feller, Monroe, how you know him?
Captain Monroe was reassigned here from a regiment in the north. Apparently, the news of our conflict has spread all the way to Washington. He's a good man. He wants to help.
Well, I guess that's something at least.
The army aren't all bad men. Just as my people aren't all good. But this Colonel Favors, he walks an old line. He's obstinate and he hates Monroe. I just hope between us we can work this out.
Hmm.
It's just up ahead. What's happened?
No!
It can't be.
Uh-oh.
No! They destroyed everything!
I need to find the Chinupa.
Who would do this?
Someone who wanted to enrage you.
Help me look around, please. The Chinupa is gone.
What is it?
A ceremonial pipe. There must be some clues to what happened here.
There's some whiskey here.
Okay. Let me give this some more thought. Thank you, Mr. Morgan.
Is this right over here? Some logs.
There's some logs here they must have used as kindling.
So that all the way over there. Some more whiskey.
Sure looks like they was doing some drinking.
Please, come look at this. An empty bottle.
Well, if they drank all that, they couldn't have gotten too far.
Yeah, well, still no sign of the Chinupa.
I think that's some down there. Another flask here.
Whiskey. Bastards are having a party up here.
Quick, Mr. Morgan. There's someone down there. Do you have any binoculars?
Oh, there they are. These brave men. Some of Colonel Favor's men. They must have been the ones who did this.
Are you surprised this happened?
Not at all. But I hope we were past this.
Well, you got land they want. Land with oil.
They moved us here. They've taken everything we had.
I signed 3 treaties myself, and they've broken each one.
Now they've taken the last hope. Now my people are going to want a war. A war they can't win.
Not if I get it back.
Get it back?
Yeah, I'm gonna go in, get your Chinupa, no one will be any the wiser.
What you do?
Alright, let's go to the camp. I'm gonna leave my horse up there just so that I can go in stealthily.
Captain Ben.
No. France is near. It's near France. Well, it's in France. Indian is just from here. Where are you from?
Me?
I'm Polish. From the Wadi.
Gun oil.
Must be imagining things. Huh? What's got this horse spooked, huh?
There we go. Easy peasy. I'm the master of stealth. For the most part, at least. I have my moments. I think I got very lucky there.
Got your things, I think.
Yes, thank you.
I'm very sorry about this.
Even sacred things are only things. People, the heart, matter more. Was anyone hurt?
No one was killed.
Well done, well done. I wish my son knew such restraint. My people owe you a great debt. And I'm giving you very little. But please, take this. We believe it to be sacred.
Thank you.
Thank you. Take those herbs I gave you, please. And most of all, I hope you can find peace within yourself.
A man who, not so long ago, I would have found weak and pathetic. Now I see as wise and thoughtful and sensible. I would love to help him, or at least stop Dutch pushing his son to do something real stupid.
All right. Owl feather trinket. Permanently reduces health stamina and Deadeye core drain. Not bad. Alright. That will do it for this time on the stream. When we come back, I'm probably going to stream tomorrow. The most part, or at least I think I plan on streaming tomorrow. Probably be doing some Fallout 76, see what's going on that game. Yeah. Let's see who we can raid. Let's see. Wednesday, probably do some Battlefield or some more Fallout, depending on how I feel. And Friday, we shall return back to Red Dead. Let's see, let's raid. Let's raid this guy. Hope I typed his name in right. Yep. Looks good. Alright. Thank you everybody for coming out tonight and hanging out. And I will catch you guys on the next one. I will catch everybody later. Have a good night, everyone.